short. Good afternoon. It's good to have you today. My name is Casey Childers. I'm the Minister of Music and Organist here at First Christian Church, and we're grateful that you have taken the time to be with us today, whether you are here in person or via live stream. We're just grateful that you've taken the opportunity to settle into some music today and have a little refuge where you can sit and listen and take it all in. If you have a cell phone, just take a moment, make sure it's on silent, and turn it off if you're able. If you need restrooms and aren't familiar with our facilities, they're located through the store along the back hallways. And I just want to say, this has been a great series. Over the summer, it's been great to have people back in the sanctuary, to have live music again. It has been so refreshing for my heart, and I hope it has been for yours too. This is our last concert as part of this series. However, if you look in your program, there's a description of our sesquicentennial celebration. If you don't know the definition of that, that's our 150th anniversary that we're coming up on this year. And we're celebrating that by our culminating weekend in September. On September 24th, we're going to have our 9th annual Music for Hope concert. This is a great concert where we all come together in this community. Musicians, professionals, amateurs, people who just love to sing, doesn't matter. We're here to celebrate music, to celebrate love and unity, and to provide a resource for Hope Station through Love Offering. And we're so grateful for this chance. And then in December, we will have our 10th annual Advent series, which is a noonday series, much like this in December. So every Wednesday in December, you can come out and enjoy the music online or in person again. Hopefully, we look forward to that. I just want to say thank you again for all who are here. In your program, there's a large piece of paper, and it shows all who have contributed to the series over the course of the summer. Thank you for your donations. And on the back side of that, there is a translation for our German piece that we are sharing. And if you want to follow along, it describes in detail what you will be hearing. I won't say much more, but we are delighted to have Elizabeth Winstead with us as she sings, and Cindy Darden on the piano, and Jack Fisher on the clarinet this morning, afternoon. But thank you again for being here and for your support. And join me in welcoming these folks with us this afternoon.
Thank you. As Casey said, it is such a pleasure to be in front of real live people. I did an Advent series concert back in December, and we did it, you know, for a live stream, and I was grateful just for the opportunity to do that. And but it's just wonderful to be here in front of real people. So thank you for attending. We are going to begin today with. And I'm going to tell you about the songs. The first thing on the program is Oh, Had I Jubal's Lyre from Joshua by George Frederick Handel. And there are references to a couple of biblical figures, and I feel compelled to tell you about them. Jubal, you will find in Genesis, and he was the first musician and the inventor of the lyre. And Miriam is in Exodus, the sister of Aaron, and she sang a victory song with Moses as they were leading the Israelites out of Egypt. And the song is, the singer is longing for artistic expression. In the last half of the song, there's the statement, "My humble strains but faintly show how much to heaven and thee I owe." This is Oh Had I Jubal's Lyre.
Oh, had I Jubal's Lyre? Had I Jubal's lyre, or Miriam's tuneful voice? Or had I Jubal's lyre, or Miriam's tuneful voice? To songs like his I would aspire, in songs like hers, in songs like hers,
is a big work that I told Casey when she asked me to do the series. I said, I would really love to sing this again. I haven't sung it in about 12 years, and I've forgotten how hard this thing is. So it's been a lot of fun putting this back together. I want to mention that Cindy is wonderful, and it's been such a pleasure to get to work with her, and I've never worked with her before. And working with Jack has been such a pleasure. I just wanted to say that so that everybody knows how much I appreciate these wonderful musicians that I have the opportunity to sing with. The Shepherd on the Rock, this is in German, so you do have your translation available if you would like to kind of see exactly what all that means. But Schubert wrote this. It is a lied, which is a song, for soprano, clarinet, and piano. And he wrote this in 1828. That is also the year that he died, so he never had an opportunity to actually hear this performed. He wrote it for a very famous soprano who was a friend of his, and she asked him to write a piece that would allow her to express a wide range of feelings. So this is in three parts, and the first part is about a lonely shepherd who listens to the echoes of his song from the valley below him. The second part is darker, and the shepherd is consumed by misery. But then the third part, the shepherd's spirits are lifted as he contemplates the coming of spring.
Thank you.
Thank you. ich mich verzig zum Wandern bereit, den Frühling willkommen. O Frühling, meine Freud, der Frühling willkommen, der Frühling, meine Freud, nun mach ich mich verzig.
Program music, you're supposed to listen for real things, meowing, stretching. Her exotic name is from her characteristic walking, reminiscent of a Spanish dancer no longer in her prime.
I don't know that I want to follow that. Thanks, Jack. Next up, we'll be performing three spirituals, the first of which is Wayfaring Stranger, and this arrangement is by John Jacob Niles. And this is it's an American folk song, actually, and it's about a plaintive soul on a journey through life.
Stranger, while
The next two spirituals are tunes that you will probably recognize, almost certainly. I'll announce them both at the same time. The first is Deep River, and you've probably sung it many times from your hymnal. And the second is Give Me Jesus. And both of these arrangements are by Mark Hayes, so they're traditional tunes with these beautiful piano arrangements. So thank you, Cindy. These are wonderful. These, like most spirituals, they're songs of hope and longing and expressing desire for peace and freedom in the afterlife.
Deep river, my home. dark midnight was my cry. Dark midnight was my cry. Dark midnight was my cry. Give me Jesus. Give me Jesus. Give me Jesus.
Program today, that those spirituals are wonderful, but they are rather mournful, and I wanted to conclude on an uplifting note, so I decided to program this as the last song. This is a modern song, actually. It was written in the 1970s, and it's often sung in funerals, and I have sung it many times in funerals, actually, but I think it's very uplifting, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, and hold you in the palm of his hand.